Omar announced a resolution supporting the right to boycott Israel. And her resolution seeks to push back against the U.S. laws that ban the boycott of Israel, while affirming the right of Americans to organize boycotts of foreign countries. It seems like as soon as she got into her position, she aimed her sights straight at Israel.
Well, you know, it's interesting. She's never been there. I've been there many times. I can tell you that Muslims in Israel live better, not a joke, than Muslims in every other country in the Middle East. If you're gay and you're a Muslim in every other country in the Middle East, you're subject, get this, to the death penalty. They will kill you if you are outed. That's number one. Number two, if you're a woman in a Muslim country, you don't have rights equal to a man. Mm-hmm. Depending on the country, you're some small percentage, i.e., if, God forbid, you get raped, you need at least two witnesses willing to testify against the man, even to bring him into court, and they better be male witnesses. Or else, get this, you accuse someone of rape, even if you were, and you don't have enough witnesses, you are convicted of adultery, and you can be put to death, or whipped, or imprisoned, or all of the three. So when people talk about the poor Palestinians, what they're really saying is, I hate Israel, and poor Palestinians are the reason why. Otherwise, Jermaine, they would talk about the horrendous, despicable genocide in Syria. Maybe a million people have been slaughtered there. Or the persecution of Christians in 20 countries in the Middle East, where churches that have been there for 1,000 years are being burned to the ground, where priests are having their throat cuts, where children who are Christian are being burned alive, and Christian women are taken as slaves and sold today and tomorrow and the next day in the slave markets all over the Middle East. But you know what, Jermaine? None of these four women are protesting that because, well, that doesn't fit their agenda. Their agenda is, I hate Jews, I hate Israel, and what you referred to today, which is her new anti-Semitic motion in the Congress disguised as the BDS movement, is to punish Israel for its free, loving economy. Look, there are Palestinian Arabs in the army, on the Supreme Court, in doctor's offices, in hospitals, as engineers, in all kinds of security forces. They have every job opportunity that a Jew has in Israel. But doesn't fit the narrative, so they have to be looked at as the downtrodden political prisoners of the oppressive Jewish regime. And what you have is Ilhan Omar, who's made no secret of her anti-Semitism, who has made statement after statement after statement. Remember, she was the one that said, Israel has hypnotized the world, may Allah pull the blinders off the world so they see the truth. That is anti-Semitic. This is a woman who said, anyone who supports Israel, it's all about the Benjamins. That is anti-Semitic. Her BDS movement, or support of the BDS movement motion in Congress, is the same thing. It's because she's against Jews and she's against the state of Israel. And it's my hope that the Congress repudiates her ridiculous legislative suggestion and turns her back on her. I should also mention, Jermaine, we talked about this a few minutes ago before we came on air. Omar has likened now the state of Israel to being just like Nazi Germany.
And you just took the words out of my mouth. I was just about to read her quote. And her quote is, Americans of conscience have proud history of participating in boycotts to advocate for human rights abroad, including boycotting Nazi Germany from 1993 to October 1941 in response to the dehumanization of the Jewish people in the lead up to the Holocaust.
That, I can tell you right now on a personal level, I find that the most disgusting thing I've read in quite some time. My parents were survivors of the most despicable killing field in world history, which was the Auschwitz concentration camp. They survived, emigrated to this country, became a proud American citizens, and had me. If they didn't survive, I wouldn't be here. A lot of my family is still there because their bones went up in the ovens of Auschwitz. Mm-hmm. To say that the state of Israel, which is free, which is pluralistic, which is open to all religions, all sexual preferences, all colors, all races and nationalities, and everybody gets an equal one vote per person, is just like Nazi Germany, disgusts me. And anybody that knows anything about history ought to be equally disgusted. This woman doesn't belong in Congress. As far as I'm concerned, she should go live in a hole somewhere for making statements that are so disgustingly wrong with no basis in any fact, deserves to literally go away and be ignored. And the liberal press, I hate to say it, eats up everything she says as if she's the second coming and she's the Messiah for the progressive movement in America. I hope to God it ends soon, because it's disgusting to literally ignore and contravene the most historical mass murder in world history and liken the state of Israel to it. Israel took in some of the refugees that survived the concentration camp. It was born from those ashes, and just the thought of being like Nazi Germans is despicable to all 8 million people, Jew, Christian, and Muslim, that live in Israel today.